a thrilling final.
Yeah, absolutely. And but I just think that the way Judd's been playing over the last few days and the last few couple of weeks, it's been scintillating, really.
Players posing with that magnificent new trophy, the Steve Davis trophy. And of course there are 8 frames in this first session, a possible 9 later on this evening to determine who will be the first English Open champion.
The first frame, the first frame. Young Wembold to break. Young Wembold to break.
Just their 6th meeting, and they've had a couple of very significant ones recently, of course. The first round of the World Championship back in the spring when Judd Trump was a long way behind and recovered to beat Liang. And of course, the Chinese getting the better of Trump on his way to that UK final appearance last season. So everything points towards a really competitive and eye-catching battle between these two attacking players.
Yeah, not a bad breakoff shot either. Liang, well, it's wide.
Foul. And a miss. Liang Wenbo, 4. Right.
I think Judd's trying to get far enough down, but he's going to have to put a lot of side on the white to get anywhere near the edge of the pack. He's caught that one, but he's caught the blue as well. Good chance here, if he can knock this one in. Well, he's knocked a lot of those in last evening against Stuart Bingham. I'm just thinking, Phil, if these two play at their best, we could have a real pot fest here today.
Yes, I don't think there's any doubt they'll both look to attack whenever possible. Liang was scoring so heavily last night, those 2 century clearances. And Stuart Bingham played some outstanding stuff as well. Really was one of the best matches of the season so far. Certainly the best, I think, of this tournament. And hopefully the final will be even better.
Yeah, I think this man came of age last evening. It really did. You know, he's maturing all of the time, and his game is pretty solid now, but he's believing in himself.
3.
Best of 17 frames final, of course. 8 frames to be played this afternoon and a possible 9 this evening.
Four.
Well, that's nicely done. Nice to split the red and black, and he's pushed the red towards the cushion as well.
11.
These boys are playing for £40,000, the difference today. £30,000 already guaranteed to be here in the final, £70,000 to the winner. And of course, let's not forget that the pot at the end of the rainbow, if any player wins all four, they will get £1 million bonus. Well, there's still two people that have the chance of doing that. There'll only be one at the end of today.
90.
There'd be some going for, wouldn't it, if anybody did that? I mean, imagine if somebody, one of these two boys, whoever wins today, goes and wins in Ireland as well.
20.
World snooker chairman Barry Hearn is a very shrewd businessman. I'll say no more than that. Liang, though, it's all about landing his first major title. He's come close, of course, on a couple of occasions, the UK final last season, and prior to that, the Shanghai Masters final.
27.
Can he land his first major ranking title? He did win on the former Asian Tour. That was 3 years ago, but this would be something really special. No position, though, so he'll have to settle for an early 31-point lead in our first frame.
Yes, and our MC, Mark Johnson-Allen, was mentioning about the three centuries in the match last evening with Liang and Stewart, two made by Liang, of course, and that brings me in nicely to just thank our sponsors, Coral, who are actually giving £50 for every century made in this tournament. And they're up to 62 centuries at the moment, so that's £3,100. Now, that money is going to the Jesse May organisation in Bristol, of which Judd actually is a patron, and they do a wonderful job. Jesse May is a charity that provides specialist nursing care for terminally ill children in their own homes with bereaved families. And they do a wonderful job. And please go onto their website, jessiemay.org. It's actually jessiemay.org/UK/World Snooker. And please support them wherever you can. Thank you again to our sponsors.
So Judd Trump gets his first opportunity of the final. Straight away looking to spread them asunder.
8.
Well, that can be made. There's distance between them, but from where he's attacking the red, so I think that's Don. Yeah, well done. And he's found the gap for the black as well. He's played it beautiful.
He's made the plant his signature shot this week, hasn't he, Trump?
He's missed that. He's missed it. Would you believe it?
Judd Trump, 9. Clean the white.
Well, Liang taking no chances. Too thick from Trump, and, well, perhaps he did get a slight kick, although his body language didn't suggest that. Let off, though, for the Chinese, for sure. His lead, 22 points.
one. Seven. Thank you. Eight.
Well, the way he's been playing, I would expect to win the frame from here. Plenty of open reds and already with a 30-point lead.
Sixty.
Hasn't played that very well. That's poor, really. Anyway, but there. He could have come around that red or even played on something else.
23.
No, it still might go, but he's very close to it. But not so bad at an angle, so there's no chance of pushing or playing a push shot. It's downward striking anyway. Yeah, he's got it. Well done.
24.
In goes. Caught that well. Well, we know that Lang's maturing all the time, Phil, but last evening against Stuart Bingham, see how well he played. It's just must have been a massive confidence booster for him against one of the toughest players in the game.
31.
I think the way in which he was able to keep his composure when the pressure really came on at the back end of the match, which was the most notable aspect of Liang's performance. It's not always been a strength of his temperament under pressure, but that's clearly something he's been working on. The talent has always been there, and we saw that in abundance last evening with the power of his scoring. But to do it under pressure, well, that's doubly difficult. And he passed the test with flying colours.
Well, I suppose a lot of people are thinking, well, you know, this is a Judge Trophy today, but I'll tell you what, this guy's going to have a lot to say about that.
Forty-six.
The ideal start for Liang, settling the inevitable final nerves.
I think we can make one prediction, Phil. It's not going to be slow. Because these two boys like to have a go for the shots. Or go for the shots, I should say. But it's Liang that's going to take the opener.
60. Surprise miss on the black from Trump. Let Liang in for this frame-winning opportunity.
61. 58.
And Liang picking 70. Up where he left off against Bingham last evening. Straight into his stride.
Yeah, it's like he's not been away.
73.
Yeah, this is going to be punch and counterpunch with these two today.
77.
He's got that cue ball on a piece of string.
88.
What a sparkling start from Liang Wenbo. A clearance of 95 after Judd Trump had made an error with a black off its spot, which stayed in the pocket. That was his last meaningful shot of the opener. Liang taking it impressively.
Thank you, frame two.
That's what they're playing for, the magnificent new Steve Davis trophy. I gather the great man himself will be here to present it to the winner later on today. What a thrill that will be for whoever is crowned English Open champion. And what a start from Liang Wenbo, a break of 95. Clearing the table impressively after Judd Trump had missed a black off its spot. Greg Coniglio, our referee. This is the second time he's officiated a major final. Big thrill for him too. And what an opening red that is from Liang. He potted some of those last evening. None better than that. Wow.
Do you think he's up for this, Phil?
Well, I think he would have taken an enormous amount of confidence out of the way in which he came back to beat Stuart Bingham last evening in such a high quality match, the way in which he held firm under pressure at the end. I think perhaps the one thing really lacking from Liang's game up until very recently is belief, and I think he's beginning to address that now, and you can see the talent he's got at his disposal.
Well, if you can lift the trophy today, you know, the players go forward and it's just thinking, well, I can do it. I can win this one, I can win anything.
Seven.
Okay, the World Championship is a different ball game. But he's certainly playing well enough. And we know there's plenty of snooker ahead for these boys. They're in a really busy period. They go to China next week for the international, then there's an invitational the week after that, straight back for Ireland. So it's full on at the moment. A lot of travelling to be done, but the rewards are fantastic.
Twelve.
It's all about application, Phil, and trying to pace yourself, isn't it?
Well, it wasn't long ago that professional snooker had been reduced to almost a part-time sport with only half a dozen major events per season. Now, the year is jam-packed with opportunities to win trophies, collect big prize checks. There's never been a better time to be a professional snooker player.
21.
Well, this is a seriously impressive start from Liang Wenbo. Ronnie O'Sullivan, of course, watching with us back in the studio. Ronnie, you must be impressed with the way Liang is queuing here. He's picked up where he left off last night.
Yeah, amazing, really. I mean, that first really just potted in this frame was... I was looking straight down the queue and you couldn't have shot any better than that. And, you know, a good first round. I know Judd had a chance, got in, missed a relatively easy black, but, you know, it was you know, Liang took his chance well. I think today's going to be a long day, and I think it's important
36.
For Liang to just stay calm. It's not a sprint, it's a bit of a marathon, really. So, you know, just conserving a bit of energy and just playing a bit efficient like what he's doing now, and trying to not get too excited or give him a great chance of, if he's going to get his hands on the trophy today, that's what he's going to need to do. That's probably more important than anything else he does today. And then obviously his talent will hopefully come out well.
Well, Mike, in the com box as well. I just noticed you were chatting away with Liang. Are we privy to any of that? What you were just saying to him? Just sort of nice, 40, keep it 40. Nice and calm. Is
yeah.
That what you're saying?
Now listen, Liang's a really good friend of mine, and obviously Judd is as well. But Judd's won so many tournaments; he just does his own thing. You know, he's got his own mindset. But Liang's asked me a couple of times certain things, and I've tried to help him. I love to help players if I can. You know, especially ones I get on well with. And I wouldn't discuss what I talk with Liang. I don't think that's fair. If he wants to talk about it, then that's fine. But you know, if I can help someone, I'm always happy to do it. And he's playing fantastic, not because of probably what I've said to him, but just that he's feeling relaxed and confident out there, and he's enjoying it. Which is, Mike, you know, it's like if you can't enjoy it out there, it's a really tough place to be. So, but if you are, then it's a great place to be.
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm. Well, it would certainly appear that Liang is enjoying himself at the moment. This is some early statement of intent. 52-point lead. Still some work to do to get this frame in the bag, but what an opportunity he's got for a 2-0 advantage.
53.
And Judd Trump still pretty much ice cold, having had very little table time. He won't panic, of course. He's been here and done it before. He's often done this kind of thing to his opponent right off the bat.
1 second, Liang.
Yet to miss a ball.
Thank you. 59. Sixth.
Another red and a colour.
65.
Judd Trump will need snookers. Know the significance of that black, so does Liang. What a dream start this is.
73.
Well, 95 in the first frame. Could this be a century? He had two last evening against Stuart Bingham. Well, that was an unbelievable run of frames between those two. Nice little cannon there as well to open up the reds. Now he's got every chance to make the century. Just if he can pop this one in, get himself on a colour. The rest are available. Oh, look at that. The thing is as well, they're all going in the middle of the pocket.
82.
That was a kick by the sound of it, which took the pace out of the cue ball.
Well, just look at this red to get in. At the time, I just said, wow, and it was brilliant. Oh, Well, this needs good cueing to continue. They'd have been lucky with a kick there from the blue. Well, it's easy at the moment. Got in on Berg. It really is. These pockets must feel like buckets to him. Well, I don't think this was in Judd's script.
Frustrated that he hasn't landed as intended on his next red when he was so close to another century break.
Well, he's looking to try and play a double here. This will be some shot considering how close he is to the red. He's got to hit it thin and get the power. Well, I think it was there, but he just couldn't get enough weight on the ball.
Another fabulous contribution nonetheless from Liang Wenbo. He is playing the snooker of his life right now. He's doubled his lead in no time at all. Judd Trump must wonder what's hit him. Trump trails 2-0.
Thank you, the third frame. Liang Wenbo to break.
Great crowd in for our final of this inaugural English Open, and what quality snooker they're being treated to in the early stages by this guy, Liang Wenbo. A brace of 95 breaks. He's yet to miss a meaningful ball. And Judd Trump has made one mistake, missed a black off its spot. And already, after less than half an hour, he's 2-0 adrift.
Well, if Judd can get himself into the first interval at 2-all, he'll be delighted with that. Well, he's having another look at this red on the right-hand side. And it wouldn't surprise me if he has a go at this, because he can't get on the black. And the way he's queuing, he could probably knock this in as well. Oh, dear. Stop it. Stop it.
What gasps from the crowd in awe at the quality of Liang Wenbo's snooker right now. He's walking on water out there, and Judd Trump must be more than a little concerned. He's powerless to do anything. He's just got to hope that Liang can't sustain this level of brilliance.
Always missed that one, though.
Wow, what a surprise. After such a great red once again. And relief for Trump. What can he do with this opportunity?
One. Well, he'll play the black here and go into the pack. Well, normally he does, unless he controls the white to try and get on the red. But normally, Judd wants them open, and he wants them open early. So he might try to scatter these. There you go, but the white's gone away from them. Hang on. Hoping that it would stay at this end. Well, that's
eight.
That hasn't finished very good for him.
to trump. Eight.
Well, if it had stayed at this end with the cue ball, he might have been able to make inroads into this two-frame deficit at the moment, but Liang's playing some stuff. And he's having another look at a red to this right corner. Just slide off the others for the black. I think he's in that sort of mood, Phil. If there's anything there to have a go at, he's going to have a go at it. It's as simple as that.
His long potting, both in the semi-final against Bingham and so far today, has been quite outstanding. He's just missed the one meaningful ball, and of course that was just now the black, which was a surprise. But he's at it again. My goodness me.
Well, another great pop. Because he mind that one up to come off the reds. But now, does the yellow go? He's got the blue down the cushion, but he's just had a quick look at the yellow past the brown. I think it might.
One good pot here. And Liang could be in serious business again.
It does go. There's room there. Oh!
Well, it wasn't easy, was it? And there was pressure on it because he knew he was leaving Trump in for plenty if he did miss.
Yes, now here's a chance here for Judd to counter and get his first frame on the board.
One.
And those are the margins. If that yellow falls, Liang becomes the favourite for 3-0, and Trump is becoming concerned. As it is, Trump now has the chance to halve the deficit, settle his final nerves, and it's very much game on.
Well, I'll go back to what I've just said. If he can get him anyway and get himself out of this to 2-2 at the interval, he'll be delighted. He'll feel like he's won the first session 3-1, but he's got to get this one on the board first. Not worry about the other one. Well, I think that was a springy bounce. It flew off the side cushion.
And a slightly frustrated air to that 16. Shot from Trump.
Let's have a look at this. There, and then, off the side cushion, bang. And he finished near the pink.
The table was playing outstandingly well last night in the second semi-final between Liang and Stuart Bingham.
Yeah, I think the conditions overall during the week have been very, very good. John Higgins came into the press room at one stage, thought that table two was playing slightly better than table one, i.e. the cushions, but there was a refit on Friday evening for this one, for the two semis in the final.
Event City in all its glory. That's not gone to plan for Trump.
Well, Judd won't be enjoying this at the moment, that is for sure. And if you can pop this red in for the pink, Liang will be back in again in amongst them. Oh, his head was up there very quick. Did he see that, Phil? Didn't he sort of threw himself at it.
Yeah, it was an edgy shot, and Liang showing his frustration. He knows what a great opportunity that was. He's made a fabulous start, but he's got to keep it going.
Well, his technique let him down there.
And that kind of miss will inspire Judd Trump.
Yeah. The white, yeah.
Nothing like your opponent missing one he should have got to make you feel better about your own game.
Six. Seven. Thirteen. 20. 21.
43, 67 still left. Trump looking good for his first frame.
And Judd also has the experience, Phil, as we know, that he knew that the end can't keep knocking them in like he was. He's going to get a time when he's going to start missing one or two, and that is the time for him to pounce.
So one more red, and Liang Wenbo will need snookers.
31.
There's Judd's girlfriend, who's been watching him throughout the week.
Well, I'm sure she's a little bit happier now, considering the start that Liang had had.
And all of these points, of course, the result of the mid-range red that Liang missed. Had he potted it, this break 39. Could have been his. And he might have been looking at a commanding 3-0 early lead. But Trump has done what he had to do, punish that mistake.
Trump, 39, and the French.
And Liang remains in his chair. So, battle well and truly joined now, with Judd Trump managing to win the third frame. After the error from Liang on the red, Liang's lead cut to 2-1. Welcome back to Event City. These are the early statistics after three frames. Liang Wenbo leading Judd Trump by 2-1. The pot success, well, it was 100% after a couple of frames from Liang. But he has missed one or two since then, notably a black off its spot at the start of the third frame after another brilliant opening red. And then later in the frame, a mid-range red, which he really should have got, and his failure to do so proved costly. Trump making enough points
to
halve the deficit.
Judd Trump to break.
That's what they're playing for, the English Open, named after Steve Davis, of course, the Steve Davis Trophy. One of four trophies to be presented during this home nation's
No flashes, guys,
event.
Please. No flashes. No flashes.
The next one, of course, will be in Belfast in Northern Ireland, and that is named after the late, great Alex Hurricane Higgins. Then we go to Scotland. Oh, that one's named after Stephen Hendry, seven times world champion. And then we finish up in Cardiff in Wales, which is named after the six times world champion, Ray Redden. And again, just to reiterate, if any of these two players here at the moment go on to win all four events, they will get £1 million bonus. I'll tell you what, Phil, if they won all four, they would deserve it.
Another sensational long red from Liang Wenbo. He must wish that all of the shots were that distance right now, because he can't miss. Well, anything other than a 3-1 scoreline would be frustrating for Liang going into our first interval, given the blistering start he made. And he's given himself a pretty good chance to at least build a commanding lead in this fourth frame before the break.
Well, at the end of the day, he's blocked out the losing that last frame with that that missed red to the corner. But what a red to get in. We were looking at some of the pots that Barry Hawkins made 60. The other day against Ricky Walden, Phil, weren't we? There were some wonderful reds to get in. Three or four of them played so well in the second half there against Ricky.
70.
Unfortunately, got beat yesterday, though. And these are the last two men standing here this week. We've just seen the trophy that they're playing for and a cheque for £70,000.
And it's all about the trophy for Liang, looking for his first ever major ranking title. And
24.
If he could get this one under his belt, I'm sure many more would follow. But there's a very 25. Long way to go. First to nine, of course, to be crowned champion. Eight frames in this opening session, a possible nine to be played in the second session tonight.
Well, he's looking for the cannon into the pack. Well, it was a gentle cannon, not full-blooded. No, it's worked out perfectly. That was a deliberate shot there to push the reds on.
Fit.
I think that's a good sign for Liang as well. Shows he's in control of his emotions. Very cool in playing that cannon.
31.
Delicate touch rather than a big swing and trusting to luck to some degree with position. That was calculated impressively.
My ball.
Well, that's gone slightly wrong. I think he was hoping to glance off the other red a little bit more 87. Than that. He still has the red on the left-hand side, but it's high. Mm. He wanted to be on a straighter one. Yeah, I think he's looking at the one that's the furthest away from us on the left-hand side. Well, the way he's playing. I don't fancy him to miss this either. Little gentle stun shot to get onto a bulk colour. Well, again, never touched the sides. He's queuing so well. Well, there's been one or two like that this week, but it's these two that have got themselves in the final. Needs a little bit of luck here. Oh, he's not had it.
Fort.
Unless he can play the red to the middle as Judd locks on. Not quite sure what he was trying to do there. Well, obviously find a cannon of some sort, but he didn't want that one. Just talking about, as we look at Judd there, Phil, talking about the players around now in depth, you know, the standard has gone up so much and they're all talented, but they're all playing so well. And there's no easy matches anymore. Good recovery. Not easy to cue over a red like that. Another very controlled shot from Liang. Might have to go around the table here though. Well, has he found one? Left of the pack. Oh, he's not got the pink.
Liang Wenbo, 41.
And you can see the anger within him.
Always looked as though it was travelling to the far jaw.
One.
This has now become a very significant frame. What a result it would be if Judd Trump could emerge on as even.
Going, I think there's anything there unless he's found a plant. He's found a plant.
Well, he's been finding them all week.
Oh, hang on. Oh, it might be able to get through the gap actually. He could just get through. Well, he didn't play that, but that's a bonus. Well, this is the one he found through the gap, but unfortunately, a couple of shots later, it's gone wrong.
Judd Trump, 11.
Caught the blue on the way through, Judd. He's left this long red to the left corner, and he's been looking at these all day so far. His long pot success is 100%, as is Judd's.
Four out of four for Liang.
And Judd as well.
Not this time. Close.
Well, I bet he thought he got that when it was going down.
No.
Foul.
And he's gone in off as well. Well, that was a good opportunity for Trump.
Actually, to be honest, Phil, now he's gone in off, it's not too bad because he's covered that corner with the other red. If he'd left that cue ball on the side cushion, this red was on. So he's either going to play a plant as we watch it again. And that's why he's gone in off, because he's caught the red thin. Now, Liang can't hit this red direct. He's either going to have to play a plant or cushion first. And this red is not right in the corner of the pocket.
Could definitely go wrong.
Oh, hang on. Now we've seen the angle. Can he get enough on this red? Just, well, kick it in with a little bit of side.
If he gets it, it should be a frame winner. Too thick, yeah, too thick. Almost hit it full ball.
Yes, the side didn't react. And I tell you what, I think he's got away with this because the red is tight to the cushion. Just watch this, he's played the side, but he hasn't played it slow enough for it to allow to come over. Now I think he just can't pop this red.
It's very early in this English Open final, but you can sense the significance of this frame now. Both players have had chances. It's the first really scrappy affair that we've seen today. but no less important, on the contrary.
Wow, how well has he played that to cover the thread? Another day, I think Judd might have gone up and down the table with a cue ball, but he's played a brilliant safety there.
34, Liang's advantage, but this frame is still very much in the balance.
Well, he's looking at the red above the black. He can cut that over to the right corner. It might just go off the other red, actually. If he plays this, he doesn't want to double kiss the other red. No, far too thick. I'll tell you what, it's not a bad cue ball. Just look where this is going to finish. Well, Chip can only see one red near the pink. And where they are, it might be forced into a pot here. Well, this is a big moment here because it, you know, he wants to get it to be 2-all at the interval, but it could be 3-1 if he misses this. Oh, that's clever. Trying to hide behind the pink. Didn't think about that one. But I think he's left the red down the cushion. Yeah, he's looking to bounce this off the cushion and in off the other one.
Could go wrong. Could be a frame winner.
Well, I'll tell you what, Phil, just log that shot there because the whole match could turn around on that attempted red.
He hit it too accurately, didn't he? In the event, he didn't get close to touching the red he wanted to make the pocket big.
Well, it was just in between, wasn't it? It wasn't accurate enough to go clean, and it wasn't enough to go off the other red. Well, he's played that beautifully because it's always difficult to get the cue ball away from the pocket when the red's that close.
One.
To keep good control. And Judd's 33 behind. The only little bit of insurance here for Liang is the red down the table.
Eight. Nine. Sixteen. Seventh.
Well, it's going to be all about that red down the table, and I think if you can get right in behind 24. It dead straight, you could drop it in. He's checking that now, so already thinking 3, 4, 5 shots ahead. Yeah, if he can get there. That's the hurdle, really, to win this frame from here. 2-all at the interval, Phil. He would be delighted.
With a capital D. Just as Liang would be frustrated. Might take the wind out of the Chinese sails. He'll feel as though he merits a 3-1 advantage, but it's all about finishing the frames off. And if Trump can do so here, I think he'll enjoy the mid-session refreshments rather more. Still work to do, though.
Well, not easy to play the cannon from here, but he's got the angle to get right in behind this last red. Yeah, that's where he wants to be. And this is just about a natural angle, actually, with lots of topspin. This will be pretty much about pace. This to put his nose in front then, and this fourth frame. Oh, that needs to go a little bit more. Just a little bit more. It's not bad. It looks pretty good.
Foot.
This is the red that Liang missed. I think he was trying to get some assistance from the red close to the pocket.
This is no gimme, though. Oh, it's so easy to look away. He's on the no draw, but he's got it.
Just grazed the edge of the middle pocket bumper, but the pace saw the red disappear, and now a gilt-edged chance for Trump to salvage this mini session.
45.
Truth be told, Liang could have won all four.
47.
In the event, it's looking like he'll have to settle for two apiece. And we start again, level pegging after the mid-session break.
Well, he needs the brown here now.
And he's taken these well, credit to Trump. Yes, it was a golden chance, but you've got to take it. There was a bit of pressure on these. He has the greater experience of the big match occasion, of course. He's a 6-times ranking winner as Liang watches on. He's going to have to regroup in the mid-session and put the disappointment of not being ahead out of his mind. Well, the blue shouldn't matter, although it's just the one snooker.
54.
A little bit careless from Trump not to finish it off.
Well, I was surprised the way he played the brown. Normally you screw back off the brown for the blue to make sure. Well, there's Django, Judd's manager on the right, and Danny, good friend of Judd's, and helping him to dig the balls out this way. Always been in the practice room with Judd. So they'll be delighted if it's 2-all at the interval. My apologies, I think it's Darren, not Danny. I don't know why I've called him Darren. And I've seen him in the players' lounge all week. I keep calling him Danny, it's Darren. Yeah, and this frame is going to be another 5 minutes, really. Judge should have made sure of the blue. Well, there's the Trump camp.
Not too far away, but another chance for Trump to sink the blue. And that makes absolutely sure. So Trump, I think, will definitely be the happier of the pair. 2-0 adrift. Liang couldn't miss at that stage. Some wonderful long potting, but Trump has used all of his experience at the big time to hang on in there and share the session, which he might easily have lost. So all to play for after the mid-session break. Level pegging at 2 apiece.
Yes, well, it's been a rather breathless start to this final, to say the least. It's 2-2, Liang Wenbo smiling, knowing he could be 4-0 up. He's outscored Trump by 120 points. But the bottom line is, they're level. Knocking in all sorts of long balls, Liang. But just the odd error, the odd miss, has cost him. He seemed to be getting very excited. He is an excitable character. He needs to calm it a little bit, because there's four big frames coming up here. Trump, though, must be delighted with 2-2. Missed that black in the first frame. Didn't really get a look in for a couple of frames after that. But importantly for him, he's on level terms as they resume. Four more frames to be played here this afternoon. Well, they're not turning much down between them, but of course, so it's still a difficult pot. It's the sort of ball Judd Trump often knocks in.
Seems to be looking at an area on the right-hand side of the table where you can get onto the black. One. And he's achieved it perfectly.
Yeah, the interval, I think, possibly came at the right time for him. As I say, he just needed to slightly calm it.
Well, calming down is the thing that he finds difficult, I think, much of the time.
Eight.
Sometimes a mid-session interval might have just helped him out somewhat.
Times before the interval, it felt a bit like an exhibition, not rather than a major final, playing for 70,000.
Nice.
Nice shot. Getting the other side of Bolger. This side was a bit of a bonus, actually.
He won that great match last night against Stuart Bingham. He is a very exciting player because he does wear his heart on his sleeve, and he's also pretty inconsistent when he's playing his best stuff. As we look at the match time coming up to an hour, when he plays his best stuff, he looks unstoppable. And that's how he started the match, first couple of frames. Two breaks at 95.
Twelve.
So here's a look at some of the shots Liang played. Such a crunching long pot, and the same almost mirror image from the other side. And he was knocking in lots of long balls, but he missed one or two at short range, actually. Which can only be, I think, tension in the arm, all I can think of.
Well, yes, he slightly holds his hand up. He didn't get on a red. That red could have finished anywhere. It's going to be exciting this evening if it's close. It's exciting already, but certainly if we get towards the finish line and they're still close together, it's going to be a real treat here later on this evening. Trump looking to win back-to-back ranking titles for the first time in his career, having won a week ago, of course, in Bucharest.
red to the bottom left, difficult. Depends if he leaves anything, whether he goes for it. Of course, he certainly will be on a colour. Might be playing a screw it in and come back to Volk. Yeah. Good cue ball.
Yeah, safety success, Liang is standing at 92%. So for all the long potting, there you see that's excellent as well. And of course, that's such an important side of the game. Although there is a chance here. Made more difficult though, cue ball on the back cushion. Trump has practiced extensively with Liang and they've had some high profile meetings, World Championship when he fought back from 7-3 down last season, and UK Championship as well when he was ahead 4-1, lost 6-4. Another one flies in from the cue of Liang Wenbo.
Well, beautiful shot, Dave. I mean, the top spin on that and the pot went in as clean as a whistle. How many of these has he knocked in? They're all difficult, those shots. I think in some ways that was the best of the lot with all that top spin.
Yeah, a little bit of naughty snooker from Liang Wenbo. If he does win, he'll become the fourth Asian player to win a world ranking title after Thailand's Jas Wattanaar, China's Ding Junhui and Hong Kong's Marco Fu.
Five.
Yes, of course, along the way, Zhao Guodong was close, getting to the final of a ranking tournament in China, so he was the other one on the shortlist, but he didn't quite get there. Losing to Ding Junhui in the end, actually.
It would do his world ranking a power of good as well. £70,000, he got up to number 12 in the list, so really bed himself into the top 16.
11.
I guess it was always going to be difficult for Liang to come out after how brilliantly he played last night. The end of that match with Stuart Bingham, the last five or six frames were just as good as anything you'll ever see from both players. He'll sleep on it and come out and play like that again. He did start with two breaks of 95 though, so wasn't far behind it.
80.
Well, we've got snooker royalty coming later to present the trophy in his own name. Steve Davis, who of course has taken part in so many of these Sundays over the years, particularly of course through the 1980s, the big finals. It's been a really entertaining start to this one.
25. 26. Yep.
'Kay. Just pushing that lead away from the other two.
32.
Well, of course, he got going with a screaming long red with the top spin into the right corner pocket, which has been his kind of trademark over the course of this match and I guess throughout the tournament.
39.
30. Just swinging this round a couple of cushions. Back to the opposite corner.
Fort.
Seems to have got his composure back, which he may have lost just before the interval. He blows hot and cold, but when he's hot, goodness, what a player.
40.
Even that shot, Cannon has to be precisely played. He's got two reds available, and indeed a third to the middle.
47.
I think the point is, Dave, he looks like he's playing well enough to win a ranking tournament. You know, it's not just in little spells. It's enough is there. We know he's got the ability. You know, within his capabilities to lift this trophy tonight.
Yes, as he stands over frame ball, he played. He couldn't have played any better, could he,
55.
In the semi-final. When he got to the UK final last season, the semi-final against David Grace was a bit of a scrap fest, frankly. Last night, he just played great stuff to beat Bingham and must have come in today really fancying his chances, particularly as he has beaten Trump, as I mentioned, three times out of five. I do think the interval has helped him here, though, because he was getting a little overexcited before the break.
63.
Well, the frame is safe. I don't even think that Judd would carry on should Liang Wenbo miss this. So he hasn't missed it, so frame is certainly
64.
Over. And he has back in front. I think Ronnie O'Sullivan said it's a long match, you know, players will win and lose frames, but psychologically, if it had gone behind having led 2-0, there's no getting away from it. It would have been
69.
Quite a serious blow.
70.
Well, now again, he's just falling short with the century on, but he's back in front. 76 to break. This is turning into a really cracking final. And Liang Wenbo just composing himself at the mid-session and taking the lead once again. Three frames to play this afternoon. He leads Judd Trump 3-2.
Thank you. Frame six, Judd Trump to break.
The Steve Davis Trophy is what Judd Trump and Liang Wenbo are playing for here in Manchester today. And at the moment, it's advantage China. Liang Wenbo leading 3-2. Three frames to play here now this afternoon. First to nine tonight. Walks away with that trophy and the £70,000 first prize. And it's worth mentioning again that whoever does win will go to Belfast with a lot of attention on them, because, of course, if anyone wins all four home series events, they win £1 million bonus.
Yeah, I guess if you go back to the year of Steve Davis, of course, as you've explained, we'll be here tonight, when he dominated the game, and the Hendry years of the 90s, they would fancy winning all four. Today, of course, in this age, the tournaments are shared out quite a lot because the standard is so high and so many good players. Well, that's a good shot from a good player. Liang just getting the cue ball back there. I mean, he could have not been certain the red was going to go over the pocket and it would be covered by the yellow. Certainly be good to see Steve Davis, the nugget here later on. I mean, he is, in my opinion, one of the all-time legends of the game. Not many people I know that would argue with that. Not so involved in snooker, but he would be, if he's watching, a huge fan of a match like this, these two players playing the game differently to perhaps how he did. Just an admirer of the game. Well, that was a little bit of a blur. He had a look. Well, that's outrageously unlucky, Dave. He's not the green in. That's just... That's not fair, I'm afraid. Another brilliant plant, and who knew that could go in, that green? Well, that really is outrageously bad luck. Well, he's not held it very well.
One.
I don't know what he gave it. The full get up of the shot there must have kept Judd Trump quite interested, but as it, in the end, it wasn't all that badly played. When you're sitting in your chair, often the body language of your opponent is all you've got.
Eight.
Nine. 60. I wonder how significant that piece of bad luck from
70.
Judd Trump will be. Because you'll see very little worse than that, or more unfortunate. And they always say that how good and bad luck, well, it all evens itself out in the end. But when? Over a frame, a match, a season, a career? When does it level itself out? It might not do in this final, in which case... Liang Wei will win his first major ranking tournament. It doesn't always even itself out, does it? It surely can't do.
No, and it depends when you get it. You know, that was a vital time for something to go wrong for Trump. I mean, just sat out the last frame. Could conceivably have made it 3-3 had the green not gone in. There's one stat we don't have is luck, success. Got everything else.
Yeah, I think a few players are considered luckier than others. Stuart Bingham, they call ball run, don't they? Didn't have much luck last night running into the brilliant Lian Wenbo. That man will be ruining his luck right now sitting there. But it plays a part. It plays a part in all sport, but in snooker it seems to be occasionally very cruel how the ball run can go against a player and for another. A beautiful shot. I mean, he's nudged those reds out to perfection. He would just whizzed his way through them.
That's the thing about the 40. Bad luck. It's significant if your opponent makes the most of the opening that he unexpectedly gets. If he doesn't, you can forget about it. Trump can't blame himself for what happened, but it's still annoying.
Forty-nine.
55. Just trying to get to the bottom of the cue ball here from bridging over. It's not an easy shot with a bit of stun.
56.
All shots are coming alike right now. Might just nudge into the pink or just short of that. Play gently all the same. Didn't need to do that, but he's in complete control. This red is enough. There'll be 67 on when this is potted. There'll be 68 in front.
So
Judd Trump was very unlucky to have knocked that green in, having got in. Liang has been pretty merciless here.
Seventh.
Could do with this red in as well. It's two snookers at the moment. But now it's going to be 4-2 71. For sure. Bottom line is, Liang is playing great snooker. He could conceivably be 6-0 up.
He's taken high-value colours, so he's not even lost position at any point during this break. That's always the evidence there.
77.
Three pinks and seven blacks. He's never ended up past the blue spot, or even hardly ever past the pink spot in this break.
84.
The other thing about this break is deceptively quick. 6 minute break this, and it's approaching a century, and that's not very long. You don't think of him as one of the quickest players in the game, but he's pretty fluent when he gets going. And it makes for an attractive session of snooker against Trump.
92.
And I think tonight we can expect more of the same. It's not to be missed this evening.
90. Well, the red stays out. That's the third break he's had in the 90s in this final. Could be a big moment that. Judd Trump unlucky. Liang Wenbo did what he had to do, which is make the most of the opening he got. So for the second time, he's two frames in front. A big two frames coming up here this afternoon for Judd Trump, because Liang Wenbo leads the final 4-2. Welcome back to Event City Manchester, the final of the English Open. These are the match stats. 4-2 the score to Liang Wenbo against Judd Trump. Look at the total points, over 300 in front. Pot success up by 5%. It's made the highest breaks. And 10% up on the safety stats, and also the long potting as well. Excellent. All excellent from Liang Wenbo. The last frame, though, he had a bit of help to get in. Judd Trump was unlucky. We can see again what happened here. Red came back from the table, not the green in, just really unlucky. And from that, Liang made a 92 break.
Well, it's an outrageous piece of bad fortune, isn't it? I mean, there's no getting away from it. Some things you can avoid, which happened, but really that was something you could never have predicted. And it cost him the
Thank
frame.
Thank you, frame seven.
Well, we've got now two big frames left here this afternoon. Trump, you feel, has got to win at least one of them. It's 4-2 to Liang. 5-3 down last week to Ronnie O'Sullivan, won 9-8. 6-2 to a player as confident at the moment as Liang Wenbo. That'll be tough, even though, of course, he did hit back at the Crucible against him from 6-3 at halftime. 6-2 at a fair old pace this final. Average frame time just over 13 minutes. That's quick. You know, you expect it maybe to be a bit cagey early on, but there you are, just 13 minutes. It's going to be a bit of a gap between sessions. A few of the spectators may take themselves off to the Trafford Centre next door, a huge shopping complex. I went and had a look yesterday. I had to get a taxi back. That's how big it is. Slight overstatement, but that's where we are. Outside the city centre. Huge complex. Of course, we had 8 tables here at the start of the week. Reminder that all the action today from the final is in high definition on Eurosport.
Quite pacey, this. Well, it's okay, but I don't think he hit it quite that hard. With the red in bulk, but clearly covered up by the yellow, and plenty of other reds also blocked off by the green. Of course, if he plays a safety shot back to bulk, then, well, he's got to be on the right side of the table. Anywhere over the left, he leaves the red by the yellow to the middle. So he's in a bit of trouble here. Playing, showing the referee the line of the shot, but I get the feeling he's playing a similar shot to the previous one cushion, but maybe either into the bunch or the bottom red is the one he's trying to lay on. Pace is everything here, and again it's a little bit heavy-handed. His touch has deserted him on the last two shots. The line of the shot, very good. But Judd Trump might be potting his first ball for coming up to 26 minutes if this goes in. In fact, that is since before the mid-session. He's not potted a single ball. He actually did pot one, but it ended up being a foul when he knocked the green in. Very confidently played, David Pace. And I think he's got to do more of the same on this black. These are never easy, but the accuracy required here is similar. Because again, he's got to use a bit of pace to get out of there onto the next red. Oh, that's a rotten kick. That was a pretty vile kick.
Judd Trump, one.
Well, if Judd Trump didn't have bad luck, he wouldn't have any luck. That comes after the green going in last frame. And now look at this, horrible contact. Throwing the black right off line. Pretty miserable spell for Trump.
Yeah, I mean, outrageous bad luck. I mean, it was a horror contact. I've not seen one as bad as that this week.
One.
Well, again, it's down to Liang to show no mercy.
It makes you feel out there. If you're sitting where Judd is in that seat and you've had those two pieces of bad luck, you
six.
maybe it's just not going to happen for you. This has just gone straight on. Squared up the angle, straightened it up. But you do wonder, is it my day or is it somebody else's day when those kind of things happen?
Seven.
Well, I thought it'd been quite exciting so far.
Ten.
Well, the way he's been playing, there's every chance he could win the frame again here. Wouldn't want to preempt that, but He knows he's capable because in the balls he's been playing beautifully. He's been staying in perfect position, playing fluently. He's got to do it again, but he's capable.
If he does win tonight, there's a long way to go yet, but if he does, there could be some celebration. He likes to celebrate. Did last night. Can't blame him the way he played against Stuart Bingham. Ooh, that black's just wriggled in.
Yes, and for that reason, he's not perfectly behind the next red. He hit it too thick, and he was up on this, worried that he
80.
Left it over the pocket. Would have been the miss of the week, I think, that one. But once again, a great recovery, perfectly in back in behind the blue.
Well, we'll never know what Trump would have made from the plant last frame, or indeed would have made from the visit this frame, but for the kick. But T4. The point is, he didn't get the chance to show us. Trump said he's been trying to copy Mark Selby and his approach. And that's what he has to do in that chair, just compose himself, because 32. He could come back to the table. He needs to be ready if he does.
So
the option's running a little bit thin. Those two reds up to the right, I'm sure they both go to the right corner. Might be playing on those. Getting into the cue ball with the screw, and he's a left-hander. But even then, I don't think he can reach this one. It's a good shot, though.
Fort.
As a surprise, he could have just played the left-hand red of the two and run it in. Maybe it wasn't quite straight enough, but rest shots sometimes can be missed, even when you're not missing shots usually. Sometimes it's just a little bit different using the rest of what you've been doing before.
One.
Can't say he rushed it or anything, he just didn't line it up properly. He's suffered a little bit, and he wants to make Leung sit in his chair and suffer himself and think what might have been. Quite an important passage of play, I think, this one.
Nine.
Yes, and this is why, as I mentioned, the time spent in his chair was important. And in fairness, he sat there placid. He wasn't shaking his head or tutting or grumbling or chuntering or any of that. Just sat waiting quietly for this chance.
50, 60, 22.
Well, once again, perfectly judged. Just dropping the cue ball through for red here is pretty simple. Well, it's quite tense in here. It's the first session of two. It might get even more so tonight.
48.
The audience watching this final. A good crowd in this afternoon. I realise that this is a very important little run of play. A lot of suspense in the air. And again, well played.
That's right, if Trump can win this frame, even if he loses the last, 5-3, he's very much in it. But 5-2, going to the last frame, a chance of 6-2, then the pressure's really on him. So this really important visit.
Sometimes see first session of two in a final, it can be a little bit flat, because you know it's all going to really kick off in the evening and things are going to take shape. But this has been an excellent session. Both players look really sharp. They've won six matches apiece to get here, don't forget, all week.
43. 44. Oh no. Finished right up against the red.
51.
Well, it's amazing that he should finish in the only place. Absolutely no chance of putting one here.
51.
Well, I think Trump will regard that as a chance missed. 51, though, he's got 12-point lead. He's got Liang snookered, it would seem. I think that would have been start the car time if that red had gone in.
Yes, it nearly did. Sorry, Dave, it nearly did go in, as you say, and that would have been three ridiculously bad pieces of fortune for Judd, but it doesn't seem to matter now because that was a great pot.
Again, though, it's not finished well, really. I was just thinking, if the red had gone, Trump would have been entitled to think, well, I just can't win this. But it didn't.
Well, he's got an absolutely simple snooker. Behind green or just touch the brown. But I tell you, if he's playing this, I think he must be playing to refuse this shot. Interesting choice. Clever shot.
Trump
the
one.
Blue on the cushion. Of course, that's a right-handed shot down the cushion. And Liang is left, and he's got the snooker, so that is a very clever shot. Sort of shot that the man the trophy's named after would have enjoyed, Steve Davis, an absolute master tactician.
Yeah, and it shows he's thinking well. He's not allowing the little bad luck to overwhelm his thought processes. Could have finished anywhere. It's not bad for Liang. Oh, did I say not bad? What a fantastic roll.
Interesting shot selection now. I mean, this was beautiful cueing. When the ball's come to rest, you'll see that he's got a pretty good chance for a snooker behind the brown with the cue ball. There was no real option for the pot there. Unfortunately, he's played it badly. He could hardly have played it worse, in fact. He's left the pot on. That's a blunder. Well, good and bad, obviously not on the brown, but developing the blue for either continuation of this visit or should he get another chance. He's very much in this frame still, Lian Wenbo. Oh, goodness me, is he really thinking about going for this? Doesn't look a natural. Cue ball is, well, somewhere close to the left corner, I think. Probably not enough, but not a million miles away. This is a very difficult pot to even think of. This is where he has to count to 10 and think, is this really right? Do I wait one? Yes, I think that's the correct move. That pot looked pretty horrible, yeah, what he was thinking about.
Three.
Well, sanity won the day there. What an important couple of minutes coming up here. Trump 12 in front. He needs brown and blue. Liang, of course, is going to need them all. But the difference, 5-2 or 4-3, massive going into this afternoon's last frame.
Interesting, foul. He played it with left-hand side. Yes. I don't know why he would.
Lian Wenbo, four.
Either way, he missed it, but the cue ball hit that top cushion and went over to the left. Maybe he was worried about coming back and hitting the blue. I think he's going to look at this and have it put back, isn't he?
Back.
Yep, there's no time limit. I think he's just made Judd Trump sweat for a second. He played it with left-hand side, yeah. Which yes, is pretty me. Unnatural to be playing with... left-hand side to try and get an edge on the right of a ball. Okay. Some dialogue between player and referee to find out exactly where the cue ball was.
Okay. It's Manchester's own Greg Coniglio taking charge.
Okay, now.
They've got the freeze frame option with a marker, Leo Scullion. So they should use it really if there's discussion.
So saying it's wider?
Yeah, I can't believe there's any way you wouldn't use it if it's there.
Definitely a roundabout.
I'm told it's available right now.
Further up. Okay.
Well, that's where it was.
No. Okay. All right, Judd.
Well, it's not quite right, is it? It's half a ball's width away.
Yeah, it's not right.
The point is, if we can see that it's not right, I don't understand why the official can't see out there, Greg Coniglio. We're only a few yards away, aren't we?
Well, Liang Wenbo... Well, in fact, Brendan Moore now is getting involved, another referee. Liang Wenbo's having a look at the screen. They're all looking at the screen. It's not quite right, just a little bit to the left. Is required.
It's a bit like the golden shot all those years ago, bit left a bit, right a bit, fire.
There's one for the teenagers.
Yeah, that's right. They'll know what we're talking about, not.
Yeah.
Well, that's still not quite right, but I think the line, importantly.
Okay. Yeah.
No, Yank. Not quite. Anyway, just going back to what I say. Played it with left-hand side first time to avoid going into the blue on the way back. Very dangerous shot he's played there. He's got it, and it's very good effort, but I'll tell you, easy to imagine chipping that brown nearer the left top corner pocket. Well, he doesn't mind a challenge, does he, Liang? And he's having a look at the potting angle. It's too thin, really, but gets it, he's on the blue for sure, I'd say. Could be frame ball, this. It's difficult. It's a marvellous putt. Under pressure.
Well, it sums up the way he's played right from the start of this final. He's been going for them. He's trying to win the match. He's trying to win the tournament. He's pretty fearless, is Liang. He needs three remaining colours to lead 5-2.
Well, that was very twitchy. I think his bridge hand even moved there. But courtesy of the jaw of the middle pocket, which Judd, which didn't escape Judd's notice. He's perfectly behind the pink. And I'll tell you what,
15.
Liang is very nervous on these shots. Worth noting that Judd can only tie the frame. Respot could happen. Yeah. But on the blue, I'm sure his bridge hand moved. Pink, everything moved. Most body parts moved. Judd is still in this frame, but only just.
Yes, well, he's left himself a horrible black here. What a shot this is in the match.
Well,
there's an awful lot of tension here. I can't imagine this cuts to the middle. It'd be the thinnest of the thin. So, how much do you like these? Safety shot. Can see him going in off if he tries to push the black up the, to the bulk end. I'm afraid that's not going to be it. Tried to get the black safe, but he's failed on all counts there.
Well, Liang's long potting has been excellent. 80% for the match. He knocks this one in, his three frames in front. But he hasn't.
It's worth repeating that Judd Trump needs to pot this black and the black again as a respot.
Yeah, he had that respot frame late on in the semi-final yesterday against Barry Hawkins, which he won. And we got another one. We've got another one. Liang had a go at it. Drum knocked it in. The black is coming back on. What a frame. Greg Coniglio is going to spin a coin. And then the player wins that coin toss, usually puts the other player in. Let's hope he's got his coin. He has.
Head. It is a head. Your choice.
Yeah, just nods across to Judd standing up there. That was enough to make him know that he's got to play the next shot.
Well, he made a bit of a hash of this yesterday, didn't he? He did actually leave Hawkins a pot, although Barry Hawkins missed it to this right corner.
Played that much better. He's never been a nice shot to have to play. I mean, there is a possibility where the balls have landed that he could play the double here. To try and double the black to the left corner, take the cue ball up the table. He's having a long, hard look at the angle. He's the most intense spell of concentration I've seen from a player. He's played it. What a shot.
What a shot indeed. Liang Wenbo doubles the respot to lead 5-2. What a moment in this final. Judd Trump now with it all to do. He's three frames behind.
Welcome back. Well, the audience here in Manchester just simmering down after that very dramatic conclusion to frame seven. These are the match stats. Liang Wenbo leading 5-2, well ahead on the total points. He's ahead on the pot success and the safety and the long potting and the highest breaks. He's ahead on everything. But I tell you what, the double on the black was some shot. He took his time looking at it and couldn't have struck it any better. Look at him coming round to see it going in, and he's delighted. Why wouldn't he be? Why wouldn't he be? What a massive frame to win. Massive shot. Having missed the black originally, Trump forced the respot. And Judd Trump knows the last frame of the afternoon, nil is huge.
Yes, got it slightly wrong, that shot on the respot again there, to leave the double option. The cue ball's meant to be at a slightly different angle to the black, but it's a brilliant double in the end. Brilliant stuff.
Well, what an exciting afternoon, and there's no doubt that tonight will be equally exciting. Trump's going to have to make some sort of comeback. The question is, will it be from 5-3 or the more perilous position of 6-2? I think the only thing Trump can tell himself is he's not been making mistake after mistake. He's been unlucky at times. He's played a pretty standard shot there to put the black on the cushion. Not everyone would have gone for the double. Not everyone would have got it.
He's an example, though, of a player that, if he's relaxed and in the zone, he's very hard to beat, but he's a bit inconsistent. And as we've already discussed over the weekend, Ronnie O'Sullivan knows him well. And, you know, he's excitable, and that is not really a good thing for a snooker player, to be overexcited on shots. The adrenaline pumps to the point where he almost boils over. He's straight away up looking at this two-ball plant. Don't know if they're set in line or what. Well, they are. And this, it looks on. The idea is just to aim to pop the first ball. And he's going to plough through the bunch. I mean, these could finish anywhere, but the plant must go very close, surely. I always thought he'd get it, but position was completely in the lap of the gods.
Well, it's great to see someone having a go like he is. No one could accuse him of being hesitant in this final. But as you say, he's got to try and just keep calm now. Because before the interval, he was getting a little overexcited. Lost those two frames.
High value colours not in play. Well, that was a mile away. The cue went up in the air on that shot.
Young Wembo, 7. Go on, George.
Just watch the cue after he hits it. Cue nearly hit the shade, if there would have been one. It's meant to go through and stay on your bridge.
One.
Yeah, you just feel the adrenaline still flowing through his body after the double black.
Well, the only good thing from his point of view, Dave, is that this is a more important frame for Judd than for him. 5-3 up is a handy position, but really Judd Trump cannot afford to go 6-2 down, so I think the onus is on him here rather than that man.
Well, that's some pot. He didn't play for that red, so he's knocked it in.
Well, if that had gone in off, then I think Judd would have thought that everything was against him. I think this was out of frustration, to be honest. I think he just hit it. I think he's feeling that it's not his day at the moment. And that's not going to make him feel any better. He's had a rotten, rotten run of play. Bad luck, but he's up against a player who's inspired.
Yeah, and those, that excitement is transferable, isn't it? You know, you can't be immune to it. It creates an atmosphere all of its own.
Well, you've got a choice here. Two reds that are available behind the bunch and in top side of the black. You can run in down to those. You could go into the bunch, but it's a little bit risky. What he wants is to get on one of those two reds with an angle to flick the red to the right of the black out into play. All of that would get him into a good position. Now, does he have the angle on the two reds?
Six.
No, I don't think so. He's screwing through the bunch here, I think. Oh, calm down. That was... just
that
everything
well,
that
six.
Ronnie O'Sullivan has said about him, he's a hothead.
Oh, well, look at the movement on that shot.
It's good, though, isn't it? In the age of super techniques and everyone hitting the ball the same way, we've got a player who does things, he's a bit of a maverick, isn't he?
One.
Yeah, it's going to be, I mean, he'll be in front, we don't know by what score tonight. It's going to be about controlling his nerves, because if he's like this now, imagine if he gets to seven or eight frames tonight, how excitable he's going to be then. And that'll be key. If he can control his nerves, of course he can win. But it's usually the man with the calmer head who comes through in these big finals.
Five. Six. Twelve. 13.
Well, he knew straight away that he'd overscrewed. Is he on the red?
50.
Well, he is. He got Liang Wenbo interested there.
60.
Judd is not quite here. You can sense that he's a little bit, his shoulders have dropped a little bit. He desperately wants his frame. This is a real test of his temperament, which I think is a good one. Got to find a way of winning this frame and then have a rest and come back tonight. 5-3 down.
22.
That's what he needs to do. He's got to pick himself up.
29. 30.
Still work to do here. And this red was a bit jawish, but he got the cannon to the other red to be on the black. And he's made a conscious effort to keep himself calm, as I say, he's been trying to ape what Mark Selby's been doing the last few years.
He's on a run of 14 matches unbeaten, isn't he, as well, which at times like this will stand him in good stead. He's got winning ways. It's a lot of snooker, isn't it? 14 matches, basically almost a month of snooker.
44.
And that's a lot of matches in an era when they play tournaments every week, just about. And that's a very clean pot. Never easy at close throws.
Some of the players he's beaten as well. He's beat John Higgins twice, Mark Selby, Ronnie O'Sullivan, Mark Williams, Barry Hawkins. Some great names there in that run.
Mark Williams actually put a tweet up after the defeat that he suffered at the hands of Judd and said, well, I think 52. Judd is the next world champion. He's 2017 world champion, he thought. He's on the shortlist for sure. And this is frame ball.
It's wide.
Judd Trump, 52.
Well, good 52, but not there yet. 44 in front. 51.
Yeah, a very good 52. I don't think he started the break feeling all that great about things. And I know why, because he had a lot of shots to think about and basically stew over that had taken place in about half an hour.
So there you see it, Trump needing one red. And 5-3, you know, is actually a result. He could have been 4-0 down at the interval. Just desperately doesn't want 6-2. And that red's gone in, so it's snooker's required. And he will hope not only to produce his best form tonight, but also get that little bit of luck that he hasn't had this afternoon, because Liang Wenbo has definitely had it. But this final's still very much in the balance.
Yeah, it really is, and I think it's set up beautifully for this evening.
Six.
Yeah, great atmosphere.
Well, it's been a very exciting afternoon snooker. We've not even been playing 2 hours.
Correction on the score, Leo.
Liang needs two snookers. She's got a slight issue with the scoreboard, I think. It's right now, so 50 in it, 43 on.
Yeah, one more pot certainly wins the frame for Judd. I think it's lived up to what we expected. These are the two form players this week. They're in the final, having won six matches each. And if you hadn't seen any of the snooker up until now, well, you're seeing exactly why these two guys are here. Both open players, wonderful scorers. Trump's been winning. Liang Wenbo doesn't always win, but three. In this sort of form, I think he can beat anybody.
Well, Trump has been trumped in a way. Some of the long pots at the end, Wenbo's knocked in, but this is a little reminder here that this final by no means over. I think Judd Trump will take 4-3. He lost that somewhat that French second frame, but he's made amends. Good 52 break in the eighth frame. It's set up nicely for tonight. When they return at 7:30, it's Liang Wenbo leading Judd Trump in the final by 5 frames to 3.